Chalman, SAP Devs. Well, not actually. I was just trying to see if you were awake. Rich is away on vacation this week, so I'm going to cover a couple of hot ABAP topics for him. The first one has to do with using BAPIs in your RAP applications. Now, while we were helping out at SAP Tech Ed and the hands-on labs exercises, this was a common question that came up a couple of times. People wanted to know how to take existing BAPIs and their whole logical unit of work, and how to then integrate that into RAP applications. Well, Marcel Hermans has a great blog post that he put out that also not only answers this question, but links to his Devtoberfest session that also covers this topic. So if this is a question that's been on your mind, definitely check out his blog post and the related Devtoberfest recording. Now, the other hot topic has to do with ABAP cheat sheets. Now, I gotta love any blog post that starts off and ties ABAP together with a Lord of the Rings meme topic. And Daniel Rieger does exactly that. But even better, it talks about a great new offering for ABAP developers, this idea of ABAP cheat sheets. It's a new solution that's available in the SAP samples repository that helps with common ABAP structural problems, questions, gives you sample code of how to deal with those, and you can pull that sample code into your own system using ABAP Git. So these are two great hot topics this week for any ABAP developer to check out. As always, the links are in the show description.
Matthias de la Roche is giving you an overview of the current state of the SAP BTP SDK for iOS, and he gives you an introduction to how the SDK will move forward. He lists key features like APIs for supporting all essential needs in modern business apps, Foundation, Fiori for iOS, integration APIs, OData offline and online support, to just list a few. But also easy embedding of these frameworks through the Swift Package Manager, Swift Structure Concurrency for simpler network requests, and an open source AR Kit framework are part of what we have today. Upcoming features are support for variables like the Apple Watch, passwordless authentication, which removes the need for creating, managing, and storing complex passwords, but also the further development of SAP's own app library, like the SAP Service and Asset Manager, SAP Mobile Start, SAP Warehouse Operator, and the upcoming SAP Ariba Shopping mobile app are on the agenda. If you want to get the full overview of all existing and upcoming features, check out the blog post linked in the description of this video.
Hola, SAP developers. A new infrastructure as a service provider is now supported by the SAP Private Link Service. The SAP Private Link Service for AWS is available in beta. With the SAP Private Link Service for AWS, you can establish a private connection between selected SAP BTP services and selected services in your own AWS account, meaning the traffic is now routed through the public internet but stays within the AWS network infrastructure. During the beta, it is initially available on the CFEU10 and CFUS10 BTP Cloud Foundry regions. Also, it supported connections to custom AWS endpoint services as well as the following AWS services: S3, SQS, SNS, SES, and the RDS Aurora Data API. Check out Philip Becker's blog post to learn more about possible use cases, how you can get started, there are some nice tutorials included here, and what to expect after the beta. Now, for the SAP architects out there, in case you missed it, the SAP integration strategy paper was recently updated. The updated version now includes how AI enables different integration scenarios in business processes, and details on the latest process and suite quality innovations. Check it out to learn more about the most recent integration highlights and how you can take advantage of SAP's integrated business processes.